Welcome. This is Stephen Harris, and this is the Harris English Learning Podcast. Full disclosure, I am not a wizard. I have no tricks to make your language learning easy. However, if you are mastering English and you really want to engage life while doing it, well then, join me and let's experience the adventure together.
Have you seen the Cinderella Disney animation movie? It's a really nice movie. However, the original Cinderella stories are not so nice. For example, in a famous version from 1812, Cinderella's father doesn't die. And that sounds, you know, pretty good. Except, Daddy marries an evil stepmother, and then he and the evil stepmother turn his daughter into a slave. So I can see why Disney left out that part of the story. Now, learning another language can, in a way, be compared to a fairy tale. Because language learners face real villains too. Although we don't call them villains, we call them challenges. So what's an example of one of these villains or one of these challenges that language learners face? Well, there's one particularly sly villain. It's called an assumption. Do you know what an assumption is? It's just something you believe automatically. And the assumption is invisible, but it influences us. And so what is this assumption that is sort of spinning around in our heads? Well, that assumption is, I know how to learn a language. That's a sneaky little villain. Let's say my friend has been learning how to code on a computer, right? Computer code. Let's say he's been doing it for 10 years. And, you know, he studied at university, he hired a private tutor, and after 10 years, he still can't write a line of computer code quickly or confidently. So, does my friend know how to write computer code well? Well, not really, no. And would another 10 years of study help? Probably not. The assumptions, they're comfortable and they're hard to see, and because assumptions are comfortable and hidden, my friend will probably use the same ineffective learning method. He just assumes he knows how to do it. Many language learners, they continuously use ineffective learning methods too. Most likely we absorb a learning method from our school years by doing it over and over when we were young. This kind of programs us to think, this is how you learn a language. And when we use that same style of ineffective learning, and maybe it was also used at, you know, high school and university, and then we start studying by ourselves or with a tutor, and we start doing the same thing. And yet after a decade of this, we're kind of still struggling with sort of like the basics of speaking. I'll use that as an example. And if that's the case, then it's clear that how we're learning is not really not really effective. So if we did this for another 10 years, you know, would we still fix the problem, or would we still learn to the level we want to learn? And the answer is probably not, right? And the reason is it's obvious. You'll just keep repeating the same ineffective learning method. So one of these villains, like a fairy tale villain that we battle and struggle and have to face, is something that's inside of us, and it's an assumption, and it's hidden. And it says, I know how to learn a language, even though the evidence says that we really don't know how to. Now, maybe you were lucky enough to conquer this first villain. Maybe you admitted that you were having problems, and you did the noble thing, and you asked for help. And then you lived happily ever after, right? Well, perhaps not, because there is another villain that is hiding again inside of us. Getting advice doesn't actually mean you follow the advice. And this is the second villain of today's story. Not following advice. And to be perfectly honest, this villain is very strong and alive in my life. A few years ago, I had a sore back, so I got some help from a physiotherapist, and the physiotherapist gave me an assortment of stretches and exercises, and they were great. And I did them for about 2 weeks, and then I quit. That was a bad move, because not long after that, I herniated a disc in my lower back. So that just means something in my back went out really bad. And for the next 6 months, I needed 3 types of painkillers just to deal with the pain. So, and as you can imagine, I now do my stretches and exercises all the time so that I don't ever have to go through that again. But we do this in language learning too. Maybe you've received some really good advice and you followed that advice for a week or a month and, oh yes, okay, this is how I do it. But there's that villain hiding inside of us, and it somehow that villain just gets us to quit. And to be honest, we can't really be too hard on ourselves. I mean, I am programmed to not follow advice, and so are you. And I don't mean like, you know, we're stubborn and we're never going to change. I don't mean that. I just mean that following advice means essentially you have to change a habit. And changing a habit is really tough. You see, a habit has one job, and a habit's job is to not change. So we come along and say, well, it's time to change. And the habit's saying, yeah, not a chance. And of course, that's a very good thing. And it's also a very bad thing. It just depends on how good or bad the habit is. So ultimately, it just means we need a lot of motivation, a lot of energy that's going to kind of get us through that changing process and building that new habit. So how about you? Do you see either of these two villains hiding inside of you? Have you been learning English or another language for years and years, and there's been no real progress? Well, if so, it's possible that there's a villain close by, very close, and maybe it's time to slow down and face this villain, this hidden assumption that says, I know how to learn a language. It's quite possible that you might know a little bit how to learn a language, but if it's not getting you to the place you've gotten to, and it's been 10 years or whatever, then obviously there's a problem, right? Now, maybe you accepted your situation and you received some excellent advice, but you just can't follow through with the new study habits. Something about it it doesn't mesh with what's inside of you. And that's very possible too. So really then it's time to get into a situation where people are holding you accountable besides just yourself. And that's what groups are really good for. Support groups. Support groups that support you through the learning process. Look, the Cinderella fairy tale, what I find so fascinating about fairy tales in general is that on one hand they sound like a children's story, but the reality is that they're talking about our lives. They're metaphors for overcoming really difficult things. They're talking about you and me. You're living a Cinderella story. I'm living a Cinderella story, believe it or not. You're the hero of your story. I'm the hero of my story. And everything big in life, all those big goals, all those big changes we'd like to do, including mastering another language, you will need to overcome all sorts of villains. And it's not easy to face them, but many people do, and many people successfully overcome them. And that's the price you pay to speak happily ever after.
And this brings us to the end of our podcast. Until our next connection, I bid you adieu and wish you all the best in your English language mastery.